Alright guys, today's the day. We're heading to Precision Racing Technologies. My boy Sean has hooked us up. We got a cam, springs, push rods, got a freaking whole box of stuff. But anyway, we're heading to the shop right now. We're gonna pick that stuff up and then head back.
Alright guys, let's do it. Oh yeah, my boy Sean hooking it up. Look out! Here we go. You guys know the deal. Picking up cam parts?
Let's get some Chick-fil-A.
Lemonade, chicken sandwich with the American cheese.
Hey boy, you looking angry. Don't you worry, we're gonna jump back on you soon enough.
Man guys, I'm not gonna lie, this is kind of a bittersweet day, so I'm super pumped to get all these new parts in, but I'll be honest with you, we have done so much with the Trailblazer SS with this stock motor. I mean, we've been freaking ripping with this thing for going on 2 or 3 years now. We've set the Trailblazer SS stock internal bolt on record with it, won quite a handful of 770 index races, and I don't know, like, as much as I love to leave it like this, I've always wanted to put a cam in it and try and chase that cam only record. So you can see we've already started tearing everything down, got the intake off, drained the water, air conditioning stuff's out of the way, heater hose stuff's out of the way, and with right now as hard as parts are to get, I gotta be like super proactive and make sure that we have all the parts that we need. So anyway, we're gonna go ahead. We're gonna start getting like all the accessory drive stuff off the front of this thing, pull the coil packs off, valve covers, take the valve train out, of course, get this catch can and all this stuff out of the way. But yeah, guys, anyway, we'll go ahead and we'll jump on that now. Yeah, buddy, y'all know the deal. We got us a headless horseman here. So, shifter down in no time. I didn't need to take the heads off just to do a cam swap, but as much as we've been ripping on this thing the last 2 years and a lot of high RPM with all stock parts, I'll be honest, I felt pretty uncomfortable reusing these lifters here. So we're gonna go ahead, we're gonna put some new lifters in it while we're doing this. Also got a Motion Raceworks Valley cover to stick back on it. We're gonna make this thing look a little bit nicer than what it was before. It's kind of, I don't know, it was a little stockish. So of course, all the nitrous we've been spraying on this thing, obviously creating a lot of cylinder pressure, and I wanted to also pull the heads off just to kind of get an eye on the cylinders, make sure everything was good there, make sure we didn't have any ring gap button or anything like that. But all of that looks great. So at this point, kind of moving forward, we just got to get a couple more things tore down. So of course, take the balancer off, take the timing cover off, and then I got to pull the radiator out. That way we have enough room to slide the cam out. But guys, everything's looking pretty good. So we are going to be, you know, we're getting rid of the stock springs. Of course, we're going to be putting some new springs in this. We're going to be putting valve seals and all that in it. And it's kind of funny here where we've been using that C16 fuel. You can actually see the blue dye in the fuel in the runner there. But you guys can see they're freaking stock heads. I mean, they've been doing work. You know, everything looks pretty good. So we'll get these things cleaned up also before we stick it on. And then the rockers will be getting a trunnion upgrade. So we got a couple things valve train wise that I want to do to this just to kind of get it ready for the next phase of this build. Because after we do the cam only deal, who knows? Maybe we'll put a set of LS3 heads on it or something.
So I stuck my water pump bolts in here just to kind of help get it started to get it out of here. And then with my transmission cooler, I got to take these back out. Otherwise, the cam will hit the transmission cooler. Go ahead and set these right here. And then nice and easy. Go ahead and pull this out. Good to go. Boom, look at that.
Yeah, buddy, so much room for activities. It's amazing how much room you have one of these things when you strip them down like this. But guys, this is pretty much going to be the stopping point for the teardown. At this point, then the fun stuff starts happening. So we'll go ahead, we'll get the new cam stab back in there, time and chain, oil pump, we'll throw the oil pan back on it and start working the way up, get the heads on, valve train and whatnot. But anyway, guys, that's pretty much going to be it for this video. As always, I greatly, greatly appreciate you watching these videos. Do not forget to subscribe. You're not going to want to miss what we have in store for not only the Trailblazer, but the Cadillac as well. Hopefully you guys have been following along on this build. But guys, we got, I think, what is it? Like six, seven weeks left before both of these cars have to be in Florida for sick week. So needless to say, we have got our work cut out for us. But in the meantime, guys, appreciate the love, and we'll catch you on the next one.